Last year, the Huawei P10 amazed me with a much improved LEICA dual camera system, and the more recent Mate 10 took smartphone photography to the next level with an impressive f1.6 aperture and its AI scene recognition tag. The Huawei P20 is here once again to challenge the competition this year with its new LEICA camera system that's filled with AI features. I've been testing the P20 for more than a week now, and this is my full review. Even though I've already embraced the iPhone X design on an Android phone, I find Huawei's decision to apply the iPhone X design on the P20 a little questionable. Sure enough, it's trying to compete with Apple and appeal to the Chinese market that it can look as good as the iPhone X with a thinner display notch. I would be glad if Huawei had stuck to an original design like what we have seen on the Mate 10. With that aside, the P20 is still a very attractive smartphone. Once you hold up the phone to take a picture, the back of the phone resembles closely to a compact camera design, which clearly reminds me of the Lenovo Vibe Shot. The P20 sports a 5.8-inch IPS display that has great color saturation and brightness. Due to the front fingerprint scanner, it is slightly taller than the iPhone X despite having the same screen size. The P20 also maintains a more conservative screen resolution at 1080p, which thankfully doesn't look pixelated, and it has the advantage of drawing less power. Unlike the P20 Pro that is certified with IP67 water resistance, the P20 is IP53 certified dust and splash resistant. While that's a little disappointing, but what made things even more unpleasant is the removal of the headphone jack, which some people might find it a deal breaker. The P20 features a single loudspeaker, and even though it doesn't sound as great as the P20 Pro's dual speaker setup, it has a decent volume and bass response. Not to forget to mention, there's also Dolby Atmos sound enhancement built in. When I was reviewing the Mate 10, I was very impressed with the performance of the Kirin 970 processor, and it continues to power the P20 supported by 4GB of RAM. The P20 doesn't sport wireless charging despite having a glass back, but Huawei has installed a decent 3400mAh battery size and supports the extremely fast supercharging protocol. One of the things I would like to highlight is the phone's face unlock feature. Even though the P20 lacks the sensors found on the iPhone X, it works extremely well, and even in total darkness, it takes a slight 1.5 seconds to get me into the home screen, which is pretty impressive, and to be honest, I find it at times to be more reliable than Face ID. Huawei has been obsessed with AI and machine learning for a while now, and it continues to deliver that with the marriage of Android 8.1 based EMUI software and a Kirin 970's MPU. As far as it goes, I find no performance issues on the P20 software. Though you may find apps failing to keep itself in the memory due to 4GB of RAM, the overall experience is a good one with great optimization. For those who want the desktop mode from the Mate 10, it is fortunately available on the P20, and similar to the Mate 10, there's no need for a proprietary dongle or dock, and you will just require to purchase a cheap USB-C to HDMI dongle, connect the phone to a monitor, and it will become a functional PC desktop interface. This is great for presentations on the go if you don't want to carry a heavy laptop. The P20's processing power is capable of running games at the highest graphics setting, and I'm glad to report that the games I tested such as PUBG Mobile and Asphalt Extreme hide away the notch very well. As usual with every new Huawei flagship, the company has put an emphasis on its Leica dual camera system. The P20 uses a new dual camera system that comprises of an optical stabilized 12MP f1.8 RGB sensor and a 20MP f1.6 monochrome sensor with no OIS. The camera software has also been slightly facelifted and upgraded with smarter AI scene recognition features. In my test, the P20's camera really takes advantage of its AI features in producing great-looking photos. The 4D predictive focus was also pretty impressive as it is able to focus on moving objects really well. As you can see in the comparison between the iPhone X's camera, the P20's camera is able to capture certain background details that the iPhone X wasn't able to. But I do find close-up details tend to fare slightly better on the iPhone X in certain camera samples I've taken. I'll let you be the judge on which is the better shooter, as you will find links to the photos in the description. Apart from having OIS, Huawei has also introduced a feature called AIS on the P20's camera. It stands for Artificial Intelligence Stabilization, which aims to predict handshakes as you are taking a low-light photo without a tripod. This is enabled through the night shot mode, and it does work as advertised. Though I do find details to be a little grainy due to compression, which can be easily fixed in a future software update. Another thing that the P20's camera impresses me is 4K video recording. Though it still doesn't support recording in 60 frames per second, recording quality has been improved from the previous model with clearer footage and audio. The most significant camera update of the P20 would be its front-facing 24-megapixel camera. This is the highest resolution front camera in the flagship range, and not too surprising, it also has the iPhone's portrait lighting feature. The image quality is so impressive, and I love how accurate it measures depth information as opposed to the iPhone X's portrait mode. Unfortunately, video recording is sadly limited at 720p. The P20's battery life is decent enough to get you through the day on a single charge, and you may need to juice up the phone halfway if you're stressing the phone's screen on time. Huawei supercharged technology charges the phone a lot faster than Qualcomm's QuickCharge 3.0, but you'll need to use the provided charger and USB cable to enable the feature. If you're using two SIM cards with both networks supporting voice over LTE, you'll be glad to know that the P20 supports dual SIM 4G standby. This is all thanks to the advanced modem on the Kirin 970 SoC, which also happens to enable great cell reception on the phone. The Huawei P20 is a no-brainer if you are looking to buy a new flagship phone in 2018. In fact, this is the phone that I would highly suggest buying over the Galaxy S9. Sure enough, it doesn't do AR emojis, wireless charging, and some other features. The P20's retail price of ringgit 25.99 is the reason why it is worth compromising these features for a cheaper price. Even getting the higher-end P20 Pro makes sense, as it retails the same price as the Galaxy S9 while sporting a more impressive camera system. The Huawei P20 is the best flagship phone that the company has ever produced. You might hate its design language, but you definitely can't resist what it has to offer around that price range. That wraps up my review of the Huawei P20, and let me know what you think about the phone in the comments down below. Be sure to subscribe to KLGadgetTV for more weekly tech reviews, and if you would like me to compare the P20 with other devices, leave your request in the comments as well. As for now, thanks for watching, share this video and give us a thumbs up if you like it, and I will see you in the very next video.